Hello Gundam fans, this is Brown92, and today I'll be looking at the NXEdge style Strike Freedom. Now this is the first release in the NXEdge style line, which is a super deformed-ish look for, for robots. Now, it's not just Gundam, but Strike Freedom is the first release, and it is looking pretty good. Very detailed, a lot of panel lining. A little bit of liberty taken in the design, some added features like on the head, on the chest, some added sculpt here and there. They could have done a little bit more of the paint, like the blue on the shoulder thrusters are gone, red on the railguns, gray on the back thrusters. But it's not too bad, but I would have liked more. But I guess for the price point, yeah. And it is pretty solid. You saw the railgun pop off. Basically, the skirt armor is all rubber, like a rubbery material, but the railguns aren't. So if they do come off, it's no big deal. They just go right back on, which is possibly a good thing. And the figure stands, even though it has like a bigger, it's not really like super deformed, because it has like limbs, longer limbs. And it stands pretty fine. And articulation-wise, you got a double ball-jointed head. It's pretty good. I think it's a ball joint at the torso, right at the front, so go forward some. You got a hinged shoulder armor, and then you have a ball-jointed shoulder, which can rotate. Hinge elbow, swivel wrist, swivel waist. Like I said, the skirts are rubbery, so the legs will go pretty far forward. Not much back. They'll go out. Now the hips are weird. As you can see, they're ball jointed at an angle. It's very strange. Which means you can kind of rotate the hip. It's weird. It's very weird. You got a hinge knee. Just one hinge. And then a ball jointed ankle. And then the wings are ball-jointed, and they can also open up just the one way, because this way here, they stop. But the other way, they open all the way. So, yeah. And these, the wings are actually off the kit when you actually get it. But, like I said, they're ball-jointed, so pop right on. And there we have it. Looking pretty good. Now, in terms of accessories, you have two beam saber handles, can't connect, and the hands are really weird looking, because you can see, it's like they're offset. I don't know why they did it, so it looks like he's actually holding them with his thumb up like that, but still it's kind of weird, because there's hardly any of the top of the hand. So you got two of those. And then you have the combined rail, beam rifle. So, yeah, this is all you get. You only get the two together forever. Also, missing some paint. Does look a little more detailed here on the bottom. And, yeah, I really wish we would have got the two by themselves. I'd rather have them by themselves than this. What are you gonna do? But you do get an open hand for, actually it's for the left hand, or sorry, for the right hand, which is different, now that I think about it. So you can actually have it hold it in the left hand. And then you can use it like that. Which, it does look pretty cool, but I really wish we had got them separate. Because that's, he uses two times in the show, and that's it. So I would rather have them separate. So that's kind of weird. Now that's pretty much all you get. You also have an action base, which is custom for the NXEdge style line, because it's like a weird hexagon shape. And you could put the actual stand neck wherever you want. And it doesn't actually ratchet, you have to unpeg it and angle it yourself. So just remember that so you don't break it. And you can either put it in the crotch, or there is a hole in the back. So if you want, you can like attach this to a wall and have the Strike Freedom flying. Which, yeah, that's kind of cool. It's neat. But the one thing I really love about this stand, and I can't show it yet because I need another figure, but basically you get three of these. Now these rods will basically plug into two bases. So one on the top and one on the bottom. And then you can connect them. So I'd have one down here, and then I could have a figure on the bottom, sticking out on the side, like with one of these outer holes, and then have Strike Freedom on the top. And then I could also connect them, because as you see here, we have interlocking peg holes here. These would fit into here. So you could connect them sideways too. So in theory, you could have a giant diorama going out, going up, and it's going to be pretty cool. So I'm really looking forward to that. Getting a whole, kind of like, pillar of robots. That'll be neat. Now, I think that's all you normally get. I don't know for sure, because mine is one of the initial releases. Oops. And with it, there was another box. And it had the Wings of the Skies, basically after the Strike Freedom launches the Dragoons. And these actually, you have to cut them off runners, so it's a little bit like a model kit. And then these parts here, you have to peg on. So yeah, a little bit of Gunpla. And these work just like the normal wings. So like I said, I don't know if this is a first release gift, or if it's going to be in every pack, because it was wrapped separately from the actual figure. So I don't know. And there you have it. It's actually, you need the stand, because as you can see, it's way too long. So you definitely want to have him on the stand. Which is fine. It comes with a stand, so that's perfect. And there we go. I do really wish it came with actual little, at least little dragoons, so we could peg into all these little holes on the base. So it looks like it's actually using them, because right now, well, these don't come off, so it's just there. So that's a little disappointing, but then again, if this is a free gift, what can I say? Right? But I really like that. I think this is really cool. Now, to compare it to an actual super deformed Gundam kit, here is the SD Strike Freedom. And as you can see, very different in terms of the actual design. I hope they make a newer SD Strike Freedom. And compared to an actual high grade, there we go. So that is the NXEdge style Strike Freedom. I really like it. I think it's pretty cool. I do think they cheaped out on the paint and on the accessories, because like the railguns don't move. These are solid. I really wish they weren't, but just been two beam rifles. You gotta have like a hole in the one and just stick them together. That's fine. That's all I need. But what are you gonna do? Like I said, I don't know about these Wings of the Skies. You might get them, you might not. I don't really know. But it is still pretty cool for the first release. And like I said, it's not just Gundam. I've already bought Mazinkaiser, Next is Destiny. Genesis of Gallagher, I have to get. Wing Zero Custom, Double O Riser, even Gurren Mark II from Kogius. Like, all the actual animes I've seen of giant robots. It's pretty cool. Maybe look at some Evangelion in there. Gurren Lagann. This could be a pretty sweet line if they get this up. Just hope they... A little bit more... I mean, it's only $25, so... Yeah, you're not going to get a lot of paint, unfortunately. But... Yeah, for more of the simple kits, like Wing Zero Custom, which just has two Buster Rifles, it might be okay. But yeah, when they get the robots that have, like, a lot of accessories, yeah, I don't expect much. But it's still pretty cool. So that's about it, and I'll see you at the next review.